YouTube, what's good? It's your boy Fades by Morales, and I'm coming at you again with another haircut tutorial. Let's go. We're gonna go ahead and get started with the highest guard that we're gonna use for this haircut. It's a number 4. It's a special guard that fits directly over detachable blades. I recommend you guys looking into getting some of them because they're dope. And if you notice, when I'm cutting, I'm going straight up and down. I'm not trying to curb into that long hair. Definitely not trying to cut any of that down. So I'm keeping my strokes right at that line. Straight up. All right, we combed everything down. We're getting ready to use the trimmer to set in our bald line right now. Now that we put the trimmer down, we're gonna go ahead and grab that shaver, FX02, and run it up almost to that trimmer line. Stay below it though. So right here we got the Chinese clipper with the Wall Legends blade on it, and we're going up a little over a half inch. And we're combing out the hair, going up, combing out the hair. Once we set in our first guideline, I'm gonna close that lever all the way. And closing the lever means I'm pushing that little arm on the side all the way to the top so that it brings the teeth as close to each other as possible. Okay, that, and then I went halfway, and then I'm bringing it almost up to that top line. And right here we have the Wall 1919s with the taper blade, and that's a number 1 guard on it. And right here I'm doing a scooping motion because I do not want to set a harsh guideline in. And again, I'm going up a little bit over half an inch. I'm gonna open it all the way, and then I'm gonna go halfway, and then I'm gonna close it. In my opinion, it's very important to do those steps, not just go all the way open and close. And right here we got the number 2 guard. We're gonna come up to right underneath where we left off with that 4, and we're gonna be scooping out también at the top. You're gonna go up. You wanna stay underneath where you left off with that 4 though. Okay, now we're moving to the 1.5 guard. In most cases, the number 2 is the lowest guard you can use and still leave it dark. Now we want to leave it dark all the way around his crown area. So we're using it open, using nothing but the corners. We're going into where we left off with that 2. We're going a little bit higher, but we're only using the corners, and we're combing out the hair. So we go open and then we close it to where we left off with that 1 open. So using that same guard, that same 1.5, we turn our clipper around. That's called the pencil grip. So we pencil grip our clipper, and then we go with the hair now. We're not going against the hair anymore. We're going with it, combing it down, and going with the hair. In my opinion, the 1.5 closed is the best hairline length. Leave a comment below if you have another guard that you guys like to use. My haircuts could be trash or whatever you guys think, but I still got the hardest beats on YouTube. Shout out to Spider G. And right here I have the Wall half guard, and I'm using the corners, and I'm going up pretty deep into that 1. And what I mean by that is where I set the one guideline, I'm going in real deep, but at an angle, so I ain't leaving another guideline. Right here, don't be afraid to go up. I feel like there is no half-inch guideline when it comes to this guard. Same as the 1.5. There is no guidelines. You just work it until you see that blend start coming together. All the way open, halfway, and then all the way closed. And we're going to repeat the same steps in the back. First, we're going to get the trimmer and we're going to ball out. We're going to make a nice even line. And then we're just going to grab the shaver and shave up underneath that trimmer line. Okay, now we're going to go back to our clipper, open it up, and about 3/4 of an inch back here because we have more room, set in a guideline, and then close it all the way and start bringing that bald up with you. You're going to go all the way closed, halfway, and then adjustments as needed in between those areas. Okay, so now we have our number one guard on the wall, 1919. And we're going up a little bit over a half inch. And the lever is all the way open. The blade is fully extended. And then we're gonna work that blend down right there inside that guideline. So we're gonna close it halfway, bring it up to right underneath where you set the guideline. And then we're gonna close it all the way and try to get as much of that out. Now, there's still gonna be some weight left behind, but we're gonna come back and get that with the half guard. All right, now we got that number two. We're going up and scooping out at the top. We're going right up underneath where we left off with that four guard on the detachable blade. So at this point, all of our guidelines are set. Now we got the 1.5 guard open and we're not trying to set a guideline in. It looks like I set a guideline in right there, but you'll see that I'll start getting that out by using the corners. We're really not trying to set a guideline. We're just trying to get this one to blend again to that dark. Not to sound repetitive. Just want to make sure that we get our point across, you know? All right, so here we got the number one guard and we're applying the scrape technique, just turning the clipper around and scraping it along the scalp, letting all the hairs that get caught get cut off. We're starting with the number one guard and the lever all the way open, and then we'll close it and we'll work our way down. So by applying that scrape technique, we were able to connect the medium dark to the really dark, but this is the half guard and we're gonna try to connect the medium dark to the light, if that makes sense. And don't spend a whole bunch of time back here right now because your eyes start playing tricks on you at this point. Like, you could look at the blend and you don't see imperfections. Like right there behind the ear, I didn't see it when I was cutting. But we do come back and hit that in the detail process. And we're just balding out again with the Skeleton FXL2 trimmers right there. And if you see me, I looked on the other side so I can make it symmetrical, this side to that side. All of my little nephews, they always ask me, "Hey Theo, why do you use that shaver?" And I tell them, it makes your haircut last longer. It looks fresher for longer, you know? So now we're just gonna do the exact same thing we did on the other side and on the back. So just try to follow along. I put the description on the bottom of what I'm doing, so you can listen to some Spider G heat. So if you guys notice, I started putting the guard that I'm using down on the bottom, and I put my Instagram up top to the right corner. Shout out to Ivy Mac. That was his idea on putting this stuff there. I like it though, it's tight. This is a lot of corner work. When you open that half guard all the way open using the corners, it can cover like a large area. You can stretch your blends with that guard alone to where they just come out blurry. All right, now it's time to line them up in the front. Using those skeleton FX trimmers from Babyliss. And as you can see, my man, his hairline, he has a cowlick in the front. And you guys are gonna have to deal with that. And you gotta deal with it the best you can. Make it look as natural as possible without pushing anything back. And when I mean natural, I mean, I'm using that term loosely. Like, nobody really walks around with a perfect line on their forehead, you know, natural. So you want to make it look sharp, but you just don't want to push back so far that when his hair grows out, it looks dumb, you know? Okay, so now we're lining up the neck area. And this right here, it will frame in your fade work that you put in into your tapered. And it's gonna be able to expose any and all imperfections you might have left. Okay, so we wanna make this line sharp, but again, we don't wanna push it back too far. We wanna get both lines set in and then take a step back looking at the back of your client's head and make sure that they're both symmetrical. And right here I'm using my feather comb, razor comb, however you call it, and we're just going with the hair and adjusting it. We're using the corners of it too, just like it's a clipper, and then that'll help bring that dark into that mid dark, and then the mid dark into the light. All right, so here we have the straight razor, and we're pulling on the skin with our left hand. This is a dry shave, and that means I didn't use any gel or any shaving cream. I'm just pulling on the skin and following what I did with the trimmer, just cleaning everything up. I moved the camera just so that we can have a different angle, but it's the same thing. I'm pulling the skin, I'm stretching the skin, and I'm following up right where I left off with that trimmer, just trying to clean it up a little bit, leaving those hooks right there. I like to leave a little bit of hair just so we can make some definition, just so that those hooks can stand out a little bit. And right here, framing up the back. Okay, so now we got the clippers with the number one guard on it. We went with the grain to check the length. He didn't like it, so then we went against the grain, and that's about right where he wanted it. And we're just touching them up with the FX02, trying to get everything all lined up. And we're just gonna touch that area with the razor. And there you go, that's the cut. And I'm not gonna front like I didn't use enhancements. Upon client request, I do use enhancements, as you guys can see. Leave a comment down below. Like, comment, subscribe. You already know I got you. I'll keep providing these videos for you if you like it.